Buongiorno, siamo qui con Pascal Grulot da Halifax, Nuova Scozia. È appena arrivato dopo un lungo viaggio, resterà con noi 3 giorni. E Pascal è un esperto in neuroscienze, osteopata, chiaramente diplomato sotto la tutela, diciamo, di John Wernham, e pratica ad Halifax, in Canada. È particolarmente interessato e esperto nelle problematiche afferenti al nervo vago e alla, diciamo, sua connotazione immunologica. Vorrei approfittare di Pascal per fargli qualche domanda per approfondire un po' questa sua passione, ecco, capire come è nata e come la sta portando avanti. Come ha incontrato Pascal l'osteopatia classica? How did you meet classical osteopathy Pascal?
Oh, I meet a classical osteopathy a long time ago. I was in Belgium, and it was the Maidstone College of Osteopathy opened a college in south of Brussels, and therefore we were a sister school from the Maidstone College, and I did all my courses there. Together with Maidstone, because we were sharing the theory practice in Maidstone, either in Maidstone or in Belgium, the same courses with John Wehrman and other teacher that you know.
Thank you. Perché hai deciso di approfondire le tue conoscenze a riguardo del nervo vago? Why did you decide to deepen your knowledge about the vagus?
I was always interested in neuroscience. I did my thesis in 1996 or 1995 in the Department of Neurosurgery of the University Hospital at Lausanne. Neurology was always something I was very interested into, and then I was interested, therefore, in the neuroimmunological process related to inflammation, and therefore, well, obviously, it's connected to the vagus nerve, and that's how I came to explore more in deep this subject.
Thank you. Un'altra domanda è: qual è la funzione del vago che tu pensi sia più interessante da un punto di vista, dalla prospettiva osteopatica? Which function of the vagus do you think is more interesting from the osteopathic perspective?
I mean, the vagus nerve, you have to understand that neuroimmunology, or let's say neuroendocrinoimmunology, is quite a brand new science. Actually, it is reconciliation, or it is the meet with the neurology on one side, and on the other hand, the immunology. And this dates for the last 80s. So it's quite recent, last 80s, and we discover that actually the autonomic nervous system, which the vagus nerve is part, has a very, I mean, the main important function is the neuroendocrine and immunologic function of the vagus nerve, and so therefore, for osteopaths, it's phenomenal because if we understand this neuroendocrine immunology related to the vagus nerve, we understand the process of inflammation, and then we can deal with everything, because at the end the vagus nerve is everywhere, and play with this try balance of homeostasis through neuroendocrine and immunological function.
Interessante, really. Come ben sai, Pascal, noi usiamo il body adjustment. E perché pensi appunto che il body adjustment è così effettivo nell'approcciare il sistema neurovegetativo? Why do you think that the body adjustment is so effective in approaching the neurovegetative system?
Yeah, the body adjustment is just the adjustment, it's the adjustment of the body. So we adjust the body, and we adjust the body to itself, one organ to itself, but relate to the other, and the patient to its environment. And this is actually how it works with the neuroendocrine and immunological system, because also there is the impact of the environment, the genetics as well. So this is part of the environment. And the body adjustment is a wonderful link to coordinate the different parts of the body. And as you know, that the vagus nerve innervate almost all organs, it's very easy to reach from the sacrum to the upper neck, but all along its course down, right? And also through the other nerve, whom is very connected, like the trigeminal nerve, mm-hmm. like the facial nerve. So we have all the technique we need mm-hmm. to through the body adjustment for the inhibition and stimulation. And remember what Little John said, the primary lesion, it's most often an excitatory one, so needs inhibition. Mm-hmm. And this actually, in terms of modern neuroscience, is just the imbalance of the autonomic nervous system. So let's just talk about the sympathetic and the parasympathetic. The sympathetic is too high and the mm-hmm. vagus tone is too low. Mm-hmm. So, and the sympathetic lesion is excitatory. So therefore, that's what referred Little John at the time, that the primary lesion is excitatory, because I guess he was referring to the sympathetic, and the treatment should be inhibitory. And through the way of the body adjustments, we have all the tools for doing this.